Now let's learn how to create a sequence, identify it in the library, and look at the various options for creating tracks and their types. Right-click on a library or folder and choose New and select Sequence. You can also press Command N to create a new sequence. The sequence creation window appears, and we will now set the relevant settings. First, give your sequence a name. You choose how many video tracks will be created, as well as whether or not they need to be set for 3D stereoscopic editing. Next, you set the resolution of the sequence. This is done via the pull-down menu. You can also adjust the aspect ratio, bit depth, scan format, whether it's progressive frames or interlaced frames, and frame rate. You can also set a start time code, as well as an initial duration for the sequence. This creates a virtual clip to start the sequence. But the sequence will continue to lengthen as you build your edit. Finally, you can choose how many audio tracks to create in the sequence, and whether they are mono or stereo. Click Create, and the sequence will appear in the library as well as in the timeline view. You can move your sequences into any folder just by clicking and dragging it. If you wish to modify a newly created sequence, simply right-click on it in the library and choose Reformat. You will get a warning that you cannot undo the reformat operation. Essentially, reformatting the sequence will physically alter its formatting as well as the contents within. Since this is an empty sequence, this is not too much of a big deal. If you don't feel confident about reformatting the current sequence, just delete it and make a new sequence from scratch. Looking in the library, notice the sequences icon. The film strip tells you that this is a sequence, and the red triangle indicates that this sequence is currently active. This corresponds to the Active Record tab in the timeline view. So the visible active sequence will receive any edit decisions you make. You can open as many sequences as you like. This is done by either right-clicking on the sequence and choosing Open, or dragging it to the tabs bar in the timeline view. But only one sequence is active at any time. Now you can have multiple sequences open in the timeline view, but they can reside in any location within the media panel. If you wish to gather all the open sequences into a single folder, you can right-click on the tabs and choose to move or copy all the sequences to a new folder. This is very handy if you want to version or manage a bunch of sequences. And finally, you can close sequences by clicking on the Close button, or you can right-click on the tabs and close multiple sequences. This can be done using the keyboard shortcut Ctrl+W. Subsequently, when you select a source clip in the library, a green triangle appears next to the selected source. This indicates that the selected source is loaded into the source viewer, and it is ready to be edited into the active sequence. You'll do more of this later. Back in the sequence, you can add, reorder, and delete tracks. So for example, I'll create a new video track. Go to the Tracks Plus button and click it. This adds a video track above the existing video track. Holding Command and clicking the Track Plus button will insert a new video track below the current track. For the audio side, clicking on the Audio Plus button will add a new mono track. Holding Option and clicking on the Audio Plus button will add a new stereo audio track. To reorder any track, click on the dimpled edge and move the track up and down. You will get an indicator telling you where the track will be placed in the sequence. To delete a track, simply right-click on it and choose Delete Track from the pull-down menu. The other kind of track worth mentioning is the version track. This feature allows you to have multiple versions of your edit contained in one sequence. This could be used for A-B comparison, or you can version your edit in one sequence. For example, you could have one version with color correction and one without. This can all be contained within one sequence. Most people probably prefer to have separate sequences per version, so you would duplicate your sequence. However, Smoke gives you different options to suit your workflow. Here are some extra tips for managing your sequence and tracks. You can make the timeline view larger by dragging on this bar in the middle of the interface. And you can also collapse the effects toolbar above the sequence to make a bit more room. Inside the sequence, you can resize any track by dragging at the bottom of the track in the patch panel. This definitely helps when looking at audio waveforms for something specific. And finally, you can also grab the vertical bar next to the patch panel and drag it to the right. This will reveal the track name. So you can right-click on the track name and choose to rename it in the pop-up menu. This will help in the overall organization of the segments in the sequence. You could be working with a bass edit, cutaways, effects segments, voiceover, sound effects, and soundtracks. Please move on to the next video to continue your Smoke Getting Started experience.